Welcome to This Week in Associations, where we connect great ideas and great people. This week, we go global. More and more associations want to broaden their economic communities and opportunities. To tell us why is Greg Ballestrero, President and CEO of Project Management Institute. Welcome, Greg.
Thank you very much for having me here today.
What makes PMI a truly global association?
We have offices in multiple cities and staff in multiple cities. We have 9 countries represented on our board. Our strategic plan is actually developed and kind of enabled globally.
Why should U.S. associations be thinking likewise in a very global manner?
There are no longer any barriers. You can't run and hide any longer. You can't isolate. And members' needs, particularly in professions, are global. They're global activities. When Boeing builds an aircraft, it's built in 30 countries. When BMW builds a car, it's built in 35 countries. So there's no way you can extract yourself and stay here. You must consider outside the barriers and borders of the United States to help your members grow and expand.
What are the unique challenges that PMI faces, given that it's such a diverse association?
The fact is, we stay focused on the profession, and we work with enabling and engaging the people to help us advance the profession, for whatever reason they need, but it's to advance the profession, not the specific issues that affect them.
What countries should U.S. associations be looking at right now for expansion?
I'd say number one is China. China is becoming a global player in the global economy, not because they're the outsourcing capital of the world, but because they're beginning to export their own intellect and their own technology and selling it abroad. Secondly is India. There's no question that it's become the business process outsourcing capital and IT capital, but it's also growing in automotive and aerospace and producing 600,000 engineers and technologists a year. Third is the Arabian Gulf region, the 6 cooperating countries in the Arabian Gulf. The growth there is tremendous, $1 trillion in sovereignty funds that are ready to be invested in other projects. It's a tremendous opportunity.
For American associations listening to this, what is the most poignant point you want to make with regards to global expansion?
Do it out of strategy and always use your value proposition as your measurement tool. Don't do it for money. If you want to do it for money, just send ATM cards to people all over the world and let them spend your money. If you want to do it for growth, do it out of strategy and do it by protecting and enhancing the value proposition of the organization.
Thank you very much, Greg.
Thanks for having me.
Visit our website for more ways to connect great ideas and great people.